Be prepared is a motto of Boy Scouts. Simplify is a creed of the US Marines. It's short for the Latin smiler fideli, always faithful, always ready to serve. Keep awake is Jesus' command for all his followers. The longer we live somewhere, the more familiar we become with things around us, and the less alert, prepared, and ready we are. Christmas music and commercial advertisements in stores bring alert to people about the holiday season. The church puts a 4-week period of Advent to make us be ready to celebrate the birthday of the Prince of Peace. It has to be so because we can easily be numbed, blinded, routinized, desensitized to God around us. We can get so comfortable in our little world that we begin to take things for granted. Isaiah cries out, "Why, O Lord, do you make us stray from your ways and harden our hearts so that we do not fear you?" Advent is a divine wake-up call for God's people. It is a wake-up call to see this world for what it is, a beautiful yet challenging place, a place where we are tried as gold tested in fire, a land of blessing and beauty, yet crying out for justice, freedom, and truth. Advent is a wake-up call to see this world as God's world, not our own. For as beautiful as it is, it will end one day. St. Paul warns us, "For the present form of this world is passing away." And Jesus reminds us to store up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consume, and where thieves do not break in and steal. During this Advent season, first, be prepared and alert to find the Lord at all times and places. Especially, do not overlook small, ordinary things in life. Be ready for the unexpected, for a sight of the divine is in the midst of the mundane. Faith is what happens while we are busy making other plans, while God wants to wake us up to focus on his primary plan of salvation. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. Second, remember that your task in life is simply to be faithful. When Peter complained jealously to Jesus about John, the Lord's reply was appropriate. "What business is that of yours? Your job is to follow me. Your main business in life is to not worry about what life spent with someone or something, but to do what lies clearly at hand, at present. Live in the present moment with utter trust and concert love." Finally, this Advent season opens up your mind. mind and heart to look beyond ordinary life to the divine life that is promised. Jesus commands us in the Gospel of Mark, look around you. Remember exactly who you are, a weary pilgrim on earth to a permanent home in heaven. Develop the faith vision to see God clearly in the mundane, to walk in this world with your eyes fixed on the world beyond. Brothers and sisters, seek the Lord while he may be found. Amen.
Amen.
And brothers and sisters, Jesus' command, be alert, is truly applied to each of us in the month of December. The church wants us to prepare for ourselves a heart of hope, peace, joy, and love in order to welcome the Prince of Peace at Christmas. But Satan does not want us to do that. He expressed opposites of despair, hostility, sorrow, and hatred among humankind, especially this month. His tactics are to make each individual fall into his traps so that we come to the point that we welcome the Prince of Peace with not a peaceful heart. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests. So I put the work of mercy in the month of December. Forgive offenses willingly, with a couple ideas for you to do this month. Always be willing to forgive someone. Don't hold a grudge. Give people a second chance. Accept others' apologies with kindness. Remember, forgiving does not make you weak. It sets you free. Help us, Lord. Amen.
Amen.